In the annals of environmental conservation, few names shine as brightly as Richard St. Barbe Baker. Known affectionately as the Man of the Trees, Baker's legacy extends far beyond his native England, touching every corner of the globe with his passionate advocacy for forestry and reforestation. Early life and awakening to nature. Born on October 9, 1889, in Hampshire, England, Richard St. Barbe Baker was destined for a life intertwined with nature. His early years, spent amidst the lush English countryside, instilled in him a deep reverence for the natural world. This connection to nature was further solidified during his time in Canada, where he witnessed the majestic expanses of North American forests. Richard St. Barbe Baker, early life and awakening to nature. Richard St. Barbe Baker, born into the tranquility of the English countryside on October 9, 1889, in Hampshire, England, was destined from his earliest days to forge a deep and enduring connection with the natural world. The son of a clergyman, Baker's upbringing in the rural village of West End, near Southampton, was steeped in the rhythms and mysteries of nature, a foundation that would profoundly shape his life and work. A childhood amidst nature. The lush landscapes of Hampshire, with its rolling hills, ancient woodlands, and verdant fields, served as Baker's first classroom. He spent his days exploring the forests and meadows, developing an intimate understanding of the flora and fauna that thrived there. This immersion in nature during his formative years nurtured a sense of wonder and respect for the environment that would remain with him throughout his life. Influence of family and community. Baker's family played a significant role in cultivating his love for the environment. His father, a parson with a deep appreciation for the natural world, often took young Richard on walks in the countryside, teaching him about the plants and animals they encountered. These experiences were not just lessons in ecology but also in spirituality and the interconnectedness of all living things. Education and early environmental awareness. As a student, Baker excelled in subjects that connected him to the land, such as biology and geography. His education, both formal and informal, was marked by a growing awareness of the intricate balance of the ecosystems and the human impact on the natural environment. This early environmental consciousness set the stage for his later endeavors in forestry and conservation. A pivotal moment, the move to Canada. A pivotal moment in Baker's early life was his move to Canada, where he worked as a lumberjack and witnessed firsthand the vast expanses of North American forests. This experience was both awe-inspiring and eye-opening, exposing him to the grandeur and vulnerability of these forested landscapes. The contrast between the untouched wilderness and the areas impacted by logging left a lasting impression on him, further fueling his passion for forest conservation. Cultivating a lifelong mission. These early experiences in England and Canada were instrumental in shaping Baker's perspective on nature and his role in its stewardship. They instilled in him not only a deep-seated love for trees and forests but also a sense of responsibility to protect and restore these vital ecosystems. This awakening to nature in his youth laid the groundwork for Richard St. Barbe Baker's lifelong mission as a global advocate for reforestation and environmental conservation, a mission that would earn him international acclaim and the enduring title of the Man of the Trees. The formative years, from Kenya to global forestry advocate. Baker's true calling came to the fore during his time in Kenya, working for the Colonial Forestry Service. Witnessing the rapid deforestation and its detrimental impacts on the environment and local communities, Baker became determined to make a change. This experience was the catalyst for his lifelong mission to protect and restore the world's forests. Richard St. Barbe Baker, the formative years, from Kenya to global forestry advocate. Richard St. Barbe Baker's journey from a young man enthralled by the natural world to a global advocate for forestry and environmental conservation found its most transformative chapter in Kenya. This period, spanning the early 20th century, marked a pivotal transition in Baker's life, shaping his path from a forestry officer to an internationally recognized conservationist. Kenya, the turning point. In 1920, Baker's life took a decisive turn when he was appointed as an assistant conservator of forests in Kenya, then part of the British Empire. His work in the Kenyan Colonial Forestry Service brought him face to face with the stark realities of deforestation and its detrimental impacts on the environment and local communities. Witnessing the erosion, soil depletion, and loss of native flora and fauna due to the clearing of indigenous forests, Baker realized the urgent need for conservation and sustainable forestry practices. Innovations in Forestry. Baker's time in Kenya was marked by innovative approaches to forestry. He was among the first to recognize the importance of indigenous species in forest restoration, understanding that these species were better adapted to local conditions and played a crucial role in maintaining ecological balance. He initiated and promoted the use of agroforestry techniques, combining agriculture and forestry practices to enhance soil fertility and productivity. Founding of Men of the Trees. Perhaps the most significant outcome of Baker's tenure in Kenya was the founding of Men of the Trees in 1922, an organization that would later become the International Tree Foundation. This initiative was born out of Baker's encounter with the Kikuyu tribe, who held a deep reverence for trees. Inspired by their tradition of planting trees upon the birth of a child, Baker established the organization with the goal of fostering a global culture of tree planting and environmental stewardship. Global advocacy and education. Baker's work in Kenya laid the foundation for his global advocacy. He began to travel extensively, promoting reforestation and sustainable land use practices worldwide. His efforts were not limited to fieldwork. Baker was a prolific writer and speaker, using these platforms to educate and inspire action. His writings and speeches were instrumental in raising awareness about the importance of forests and the need for concerted conservation efforts. Legacy in Kenya and beyond. The formative years in Kenya had a profound and lasting impact on Richard St. Barbe Baker's life and work. They shaped his understanding of the intricate relationship between humans and the environment and fueled his passion for global forestry conservation. His legacy in Kenya and his subsequent work worldwide laid the groundwork for modern environmentalism and reforestation initiatives. Baker's vision and dedication continue to inspire conservationists and environmentalists, underscoring the importance of preserving our planet's forests for future generations. Men of the Trees, a global movement. In 1922, Baker founded the international organization Men of the Trees, now known as the International Tree Foundation. This was more than just a conservation group, it was a global movement that galvanized people from all walks of life to participate in tree planting and environmental stewardship. His motto, Tree Ties, where members pledged to plant at least 10 trees a year, became a rallying cry for reforestation efforts worldwide. Richard St. Barbe Baker's creation of Men of the Trees in 1922 marked the beginning of a pioneering global movement in forestry conservation, one that would grow beyond its initial roots in Kenya to influence environmental stewardship across the world. This organization, driven by Baker's visionary approach, became a cornerstone in the history of environmental activism and reforestation efforts. The genesis of a conservation legacy. The founding of Men of the Trees was born out of Baker's profound interactions with the Kikuyu tribe in Kenya, who practiced the tradition of planting trees to celebrate significant life events. This cultural reverence for trees resonated deeply with Baker, inspiring him to establish an organization dedicated to the planting and preservation of trees and forests. The group's original pledge, the Tree Ties, required members to plant at least 10 trees annually, reflecting Baker's belief in the power of individual actions to effect significant environmental change. Spreading roots across continents. Men of the Trees rapidly expanded beyond Kenya, attracting members and establishing branches worldwide. Baker's charismatic leadership and compelling message about the importance of trees in ecological and human health resonated globally. The movement spread across Africa, Europe, North America, and eventually to Asia and the Pacific, uniting people from diverse backgrounds in a common cause. Educational outreach and community engagement. A significant aspect of Men of the Trees was its focus on education and community engagement. The organization worked to raise awareness about the importance of forests, not only for their ecological benefits but also for their role in sustaining human life and livelihoods. Educational programs, tree planting events, and community initiatives were fundamental in fostering a deeper connection between people and their natural environment. Evolution and impact. Over the years, Men of the Trees evolved to address the changing needs and challenges of global forestry conservation. The organization played a crucial role in promoting sustainable land use practices, advocating for the protection of indigenous forests, and supporting reforestation projects in deforested areas. Its efforts contributed significantly to the planting of millions of trees worldwide, restoring degraded lands and enhancing biodiversity. Legacy and continuing influence. Today, continuing under the name of the International Tree Foundation, the organization upholds the legacy of its founder, Richard St. Barbe Baker. The movement's enduring impact is a testament to Baker's vision and dedication to environmental stewardship. Men of the Trees stands as a pioneering force in the global effort to protect and restore forests, inspiring generations to appreciate and actively participate in the conservation of our planet's vital green heritage. Men of the Trees represents not just a conservation group but a powerful symbol of global unity in the face of environmental challenges. Its legacy, guided by the unwavering spirit of Richard St. Barbe Baker, continues to inspire and mobilize individuals and communities around the world to join hands in nurturing and safeguarding our forests for the benefit of all life on Earth. A visionary writer and speaker, Richard St. Barbe Baker was not just an environmental activist, he was also a prolific writer and a compelling orator. His books, including Green Glory and My Life, My Trees, along with numerous articles and speeches, inspired a generation to take up the cause of environmental stewardship. His writings conveyed not just the urgency of addressing environmental degradation but also the spiritual connection humans have with nature. Richard St. Barbe Baker was not only a pioneering environmentalist but also a gifted writer and eloquent speaker whose works and words galvanized a global audience. His talent for communication played a crucial role in spreading his message of environmental conservation and reforestation, influencing public opinion and inspiring action across continents.